there is a challenge. And you know, the De Verbum, the document De Verbum of Vatican II, has encouraged us to do translation into our local languages. But we have to admit that a number of these translations are not published or critically studied editions. In some cases, some catechists and the priests sat down and started some translation work, and it has become the Bible of that particular language or community. More critical work is done by the specialist Bible societies that have specialists to do the translation. And those take into consideration the original language. They translate from the original language. But a number of these other translations that we have, which are taken from a translation like the English, taken from English or which other language, do not really offer us the real sense of the text. Because let's put it this way, that if you are translating the Hebrew Bible into a number of our Ghanaian languages, if you do it from the Hebrew, it has a certain nuance because of our link, our closeness to the Semitic language. You know, we will read, for example, in the Old Testament, a saying or a phrase like Moses told the people, or God told Moses to tell the people, if you do not obey this commandment, you will die. But if you are translating that into our local languages and you use the Hebrew Bible, you will not say you will die. You will rather say death, you will die. Because that is what the Hebrew says. And when we say in a number of our local languages, death, you will die, it has greater emphasis than saying you will die. Because it is more emphatic. And the Semitic language Hebrew has that possibility which we can benefit from when we translate directly from the Hebrew. So if you have translations which are from English into our local languages, you lose that beauty of the translation. That is why sometimes you hear people's translations not very refined in the local languages.